Greetings, welcome to Pyre. Come though, you find Hedwyn and Jodario assessing the current situation with the minstrel. Are you most certain? Aye, madam. I make no claim the journey shall be pleasant, but it is necessary. Hedwyn motions to you as they continue talking. Seems we'll have some work to do once we arrive in Flagging Hand. Let's get going, soon as you're ready. Sooner we get there, sooner we can leave. The Flagging Hand's prediction proves as dismal as Jodario indicated. The air is thick and foul. How far to the pit of Mirifi? All the way across the marshlands on the coast. Ida, would you join me in the wake confinement? We have matters to discuss. Jodario and Hedwyn exchanges looks, then she turns to you. Go see what he wants. Thank you for your time, Ida. I have something for you on behalf of my client. Before you is an artifact called the Beyonder Crystal. You observe a shimmering crystal of some sort beside the Book of Rites. As you have surmised, the triumvirates you are to confront during the rites shall stop at nothing to prevail against you. They have prepared for this for quite some time. The Beyonder Crystal may help ensure that you are well prepared in time. It is a resource now at your disposal, be used at your discretion. Gaze upon it and shall see what I mean. Henceforth you may use the Beyonder Crystal, it is calling you. You look upon the shimmering surface of the Beyonder Crystal, some of your senses fail, though you retain a hold over your consciousness. An apparition appears before you, clad in the raiments of the rites, but incorporeal. I sense that you are not a total idiot. She reaches for her clasp on her mask. So, the Nightwings have returned. Ah, but where are my manners? You must be the lovely reader. Please, call me Sandra. We met briefly before when you first beheld the book. When you were stuck inside of it, I was among the phantoms your companions banished there. No doubt stroking their egos. You listened well enough to that damned voice, now I suggest you listen well to me. I am bound in servitude to you, along with any idiots whose freedoms happen to be intertwined with yours. I know the rites better than anyone. I soon can whip you into shape if you but take advantage of my services. First, I offer scribe trials to those friends of yours. If they can pass, it shall be worth their while and yours. Secondly, my Beyonders and I avail ourselves for practice round rites, should you be so inclined. Or you could always come and chat and briefly free me from an eternity of boredom, You have invoked Sandra from beyond the crystal, what do you wish to do? Indeed, it looks as though one of those failures of yours is ready for a lesson in pain. Who shall be brave one of Sandra's scribe trials? You called for Ricky. You ask Sandra to administer one of her special tribes for Ricky. But the left mark occur? Well, I suppose that he is ready, technically. Though I have a litany of reservations about him, but let us bring him forth. Soon, Rookie appears in heat of the summons. Sister, why are you looking at me like that? Alright, what's the big idea, eh? There's some kind of trick you're playing, sister? The Persian Sandra then appears and affasts her mask. Shut your snuff and listen well, Carl. You answer to me here.
What?
Your mouth sounds quicker than those stability poles. You have much to learn if you have any intent to prevail in the rites. Let us see how you fare without the benefit of your trusted comrade. Say for your lovely leader. I guess it's your leader, huh, sister? Whenever you are. That's how you do it, right, sister? That's it, and you acknowledge likewise that you did not do it on your own, despite having to face my demon friends all by yourself. You passed my test, Kern. Congratulations are in order, both to you and to your lovely leader. Now, farewell. But Sandra kind of gives me the fakes, not an sister. Hey, what stuff you got? Jamora Fang. After Kika's his aura, I can do something than usual. Return so soon with her? What time complaining? I do appreciate the effort to make small talk with me, Lidar. Anything to break from the monotony of staring at the void within this place. Not that I could see it if I tried. She loves of this, or maybe of herself. Certainly, I could make talk with my fellow Beyonders trapped here as they are with me. You might expect that we all would keep each other company. There's just one problem there, however. We are all sick of one another. She laughs again, perhaps not at her joke, but instead at her predicament. I do actually get it to some extent, but there's a certain truth in this. We have been stuck together long enough that we have grown more distant rather than more close. But I had best not wear out my welcome with the likes of you, as I have long since done with all the others here. So, hurry on for now, and if those fools with whom you travel and something, come bring them forth me, and I shall see to it they learn some more. Take care of yourself, reader. You'll find everyone is feeling rather miserable. Your sense just being in flagging hands eats away at my spirit. Only the Intizo seems unaffected. Most of your fellow exiles lost one hope for the next ride. A moment, reader. There are several courses we need to take through flaggy hands if you choose to prolong the stay. It may be worth your while. However, your companion spirit shall likely suffer more. The room is just receiving a valuable item if you do drop here. I would suggest taking this faster route to reduce your previous loss of hope. The long mistress says you can improve a talisman if you take it up here. The north route through flagging hands is this small beyond the green. There is little talk among the group, creating a sense of despair and cruelty. Only Tiso seems unaffected. Later, you accompany the home mystery in pursuit of his task here. Speak not directly to the living shade, and be true to your heart when responding to its inquiries, and make no attempt to look it in the eye. The long minstrel offers these and other words of advice as you approach the Briar Mounds of Coldmoat, where many exiles of the downside see their final days. A glimmer of a shade appears before you as you stand surrounded by the dead. You barely see it, and it does not speak, but you feel its thoughts piercing your heart and mind. According to the shade, the book that you possess may lay some of the following here to rest. The shade leaves you to your work. You turn through the book, locating pages concerning freedom and the spirit. You recite such words and sympathy to each of the following you see. It is raining wool. The shade resurfaces after a while. It leads you to a hollow stump, then fades away. You found Nox Shroom. Will you put it away? By the time you reach the pit of Menifee, everyone beside the Imtizu seems to be feeling even worse than before. You sense that the site will leave this place as soon as possible. The Empire's collapse. It was not long before the Empire began to crumble. With my liege gone, his own country quickly turned upon itself. I must admit that this collapse had started long before the Emperor's disappearance. His decision to give chase after a myth but hastened the inevitable. All the while, the Rob Caller stood by, awaiting such a time as he could rule in my liege stead. He would be our people's savior. His first charge was to organize a search for the missing Solia Mer. Warriors, pathfinders, and scholars heard the call and prepared to seek him out. You sense the Darius still gaze well before you turn to leader, rummaging about the wagon walls again. Tell me something now that you are here. Look at me. Are you afraid of me? Consider the question. I've never before met someone like her, but you do know something of what happens to those who remain at the downside for many years. You tell her in a careful way that you have done your best thus far not to cross paths with her and wish to stay in her good graces. Indeed, it is comforting to know that my mere presence is still here. One per day perhaps you too shall grow some horns. If you survive this place, this day shall put the fear you feel in some perspective. Now then, I shall go make my rounds. He walks away, you feel the flow of the wagon shake with her step. She lost some hope for the next fight. Let's see. Oh, hey guys, you know, this place, lots of folks, lots of the customers, you know what I mean? So have a look around. Plus the purpose to prison, plus the hope. Sorry, seeing you guys. As you make preparations for the coming rites, you wonder if the stars above will even be visible through the dense fog hanging over the pit of Melithi. Then, Tiso seems to be very concerned by something in the vicinity. Little Imp disappears in a hurry. Ah, is this alright? He was so frightened. He was not frightened, he was issuing a warning. Silence, everyone, take cover. Rodayo makes quick note of several hiding places among the nearby crags and rotten husks. You wait. Something about this place dampens your senses. All you feel is a creeping dead. Then, from the shadows, a reaching shape slides forward, talking from shaped in raiment. The shape stops slowly, its head turns from one view to the next, each in turn. Why is it yet to hide yourselves from us, the nightmares? Yet trespass on the resting place of the astral board. We shall see when the stars muster the courage to illuminate this place. The creature vanishes into the dark. After a time, your companions reconvene. That was a bog crawling. Serpentine creatures native to the Kamiwara southern bogs, quietly feared. Indeed, that was which Udmide of the Withworm. Tiso makes clear he has no love of Udmilde. Although the rites dictate she cannot harm you bodily with her, best not to take unnecessary chances. We'll take what chances we can get in all this. Everyone, it's time.
Pit of Melith. In doing so, of course, you have disturbed your ancient adversaries, the Withdrawn. The deranged witch who leads them has big plans in store, should she prevail in all this. Now, as you know, I normally would wish you a shameful defeat. But in this case, I wish you a little bit of luck.
The crone Udmide sees your companions gathered by the pyre. A little flame has touched never warm here. Much less survive the night. Here the Schlag with the night will suffer. Rookie trots forward from you. Isn't here you old bag? You don't scare any of us one bit, you or your buddy Ishla. Now we doing this or what? The question hangs in the air for longer than is comfortable. It does seem to have drawn Udmilde's attention, however. Rookie begins to scream a bit. Then Udmilde moves her slender fingers to her mask.
Foolish, Ishlach shall grow. Ishlach shall grow. Ishlach shall grow. Shall consume ye ere your little fingers die. That we shall ensure.
Udmilde slides off toward her fingers. Rookie remains motionless for a time. Oops.
Now let us get started. Rookie. Set. Tiso, it is done.
Tiso is ready to take on the Withdrawn alongside Rookie and the Fae. No matter where you go, Ishlach shall find you in the void. Yeah.
Commence. The orbs unclaimed again. The Nightwings thus assert themselves. Now then, simply abhorrent. It was dangerously close. Pathetic. A stifled effort. Wherever did the Nightwings go? No law against throwing in the orb. There. Rookie plunged into their fire. Glory!
The lifeblood of Ishla, it flows in this lair and beneath this world. Its lifeblood, if it shines from you, in such blackness and despair.
Invokes a profane name I shan't repeat. Best beware of foul sorceries. Yes. Now end the ceremony. If I were that one, I'd be rather angry. The orb sails forth into the flame. You have it? And it is done. The Nightwings once again prevail? Accomplished effortlessly, I might add. Thus end this night's proceedings.
See those bog dwarves? They had a bunch of hissy dogs. The scribes, they vanquished Ishla. That's what we prevail tonight. Tixo praises everyone's courage and his old Milda and the reform. Ishla, your fealty in the deed shall be repaid in blood. As we fools, you shall be consumed of everything around you, from the soil to the stars, you shall see.
Boundless are the teachings of the scribes. T'would appear that Rookie's not too old to learn new tricks.
What's so strong now? Do you know what they're looking to? I mean, is there anything I can handle?
Something's awakened in the moon-touched girl.
The scribes, they whisper to me, they do, from time to time.
A devious trick from the rope collar. Until the stars align.
Having overcome the withdrawal with ease, you and the others have some moments to recover from the ordeal in the relative safety of the Black Wagon. So, when can I get out here? Well, Greendale had enough of old Milda's hospitality for the time. Oh, God, yeah, thanks, I'm good. The leader and the stars will point the way as ever. It just so far we've kept on going north. If that's the case again this time. The Sea of Souls spreads north and west from here for untold leagues. I could not tell you when last a vessel dared to sail those waters. Tixo asserts himself during the conversation. What is the matter, little one? Tixo is trying to get you to come look at something outside the wagon. Leader,
please go see what he wants. Excuse yourself and follow the imp into the dark of night. You find Fear and the lone minstrel already gazing up at the stars. Can you not read the stars yourself then, Mr. Minstrel? I fear it is not so simple as matters of him looking out when it comes to me, Fear. We shall see what the reader has to say, for this is her charge. And here she is, in fact, thank you for fetching her, Teaser. Teaser is happy to have obliged the lone minstrel. Reader, it would seem the skies have cleared to some extent. Please look upon the stars and see where they compel us to go next. We look toward the heavens. Ores, the azure star. The azure star burns bright over the ruins of a lost frigate in the Sea of Solace. The rides become you still further north, toward the middle of the Sea of Solace. That's not good. You're joking, right, sister? Does the reader seem to be joking back to you, Green Tail? We do not argue with the stars. You think like me. You talk like we can just go right out into the water. But on my interruption, though, perhaps we can. Do what? My client, Sandalwood. He has a way of anticipating such eventualities. West of here has a place called Big Bertrude's. The proprietor is an old companion of his. She may be able to assist us. Edmund smiled at us. That sounds like our best shot right now. Let's pack it up and move as soon as possible. Greetings, reader. It is good that you are here, for there is something that I wish to tell you privately. Do you have a moment? I shall not keep you long, though I know your time is precious. You bid him to continue and make clear your interest in whatever he has to say. Very well, and thank you for your time. And I shall further note matters that pertain directly to the rites I must reveal to you alone, for thus I am obliged. In any case, when you confronted the withdrawn and rich old Milde, you might recall she tended to invoke a certain name. Ishlach, the astral board. I hesitate to say it even now. You would be forgiven if you took the ravings of old Milde for mere nonsense, however, her words, as it turns out, came with a certain that truth. Before the union of the eight scribes, when the first they found themselves here in the downside, with this land was even less hospitable, if that can be believed. It was ruled over by the great bear titans. The one called Ishlach was the eldest and most fearsome of the lot. Just the same, the scribes managed to defeat it. They later used Ishlach's own height and ichor to bind the Book of Rites. However, Ishlach did not truly die, for by some accounts it seems to be incapable of death. The creature is regenerating in the now, though very, very slowly. Its vow is to devour this land and everything in it. Only then can it return onto whatever plane that banished it to ours. So, in a way, it is an exile, just like you. If ever should the creature be reborn, it shall be many ages hence. Thus, the ravings of old Milda are more or less inconsensual for a while. Yet, the history of Ishlach is inexorably linked to the rites, and therefore must be known. I trust your research of the book shall lead you to discover more in time. I hope all this is of some reassurance, and now I leave you to your more immediate concerns. I shall go check to see how everyone is faring at this time. He heads out into evening, bidding you a good rest of the evening. Greetings to you, lovely reader. I am at your disposal. Are you sloshing all the way across the flagging hands right now? A hideous place, also I understand. for I can neither see it nor experience its wondrous aroma as you surely can, although perhaps you are accustomed to it now. The night wings of the past mislike the place, of that I can assure you. We shall commit misery. Now, please leave me to mine, unless there is a service you require me to render at this time. I shall be here if you need me. That's it for now. Thank you. Bye bye.